ABC Sports presents, live in its 29th season, the Professional Bowlers Tour. Today from Baltimore, Maryland, it's the 21st annual Fairlanes Open. In our first game, Edmond, Oklahoma's Tony Westlake will be shooting for his third title. His opponent is a 13-time champion and a PBA millionaire, Pete Weber of St. Louis. The survivor of that match will face last week's winner, going for two in a row, Robert Lawrence of Austin, Texas. The semifinal game features the man who finished third here last year, Don Mosier of San Jose, California. And our tournament leaders making his first championship round appearance ever, hometown favorite Danny Weissman of Baltimore. That's our outstanding field of finalists for today's Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. We've traveled to Baltimore, that historic Chesapeake Bay city of 2.5 million people. Baltimore this year is celebrating the 10th anniversary of the rejuvenated Inner Harbor. Hello again. I'm Chris Schenkel. Not far from the Inner Harbor, Fort McHenry. Just off the fort, Francis Scott Key, in 1814, wrote the Star-Spangled Banner. And also in this city, in 1895, Babe Ruth was born. Now, the most famous seagoing attraction here is right behind me, the Constellation. 176 feet long, made of live and white oak, yellow pine, and Douglas fir. She was launched in the year 1797, had a naval career as the oldest ship in the Navy that ended as recent as World War II. Now, when she was underway in battle, she carried 36 cannons. She was in many naval encounters. She never lost. Speaking of winners, let's go to Fairlanes Woodlawn and join my colleague, Nelson Burton, Jr.
Thank you, Chris. That's quite a record that ship had. As you see, Bowler Bear, the mascot of Fairlanes Corporation, and he's among the capacity crowd here for the 21st Fairlanes Open. We have an exciting, strong field today, and we have reached the halfway point in the PBA's winter tour for 1990, and we haven't had a two-time winner yet. And the man with me right now, just to my left, is the person who has a chance to become the first two-time winner, Robert Lawrence. Robert bowled 274 in winning his first title last week, and Robert, you have to be somewhat surprised at the great success you've had so far this year.
Very much so. I was very relieved last week. I was happy being the leader. I could finish no worse than second. I wasn't that nervous. This week I'm a little more nervous because I got a bigger job ahead of me this time.
Three games to win. Who do you think would be your toughest opponent?
To be honest, I think the first match is going to be my toughest. Whoever wins that first match, whoever I have to bowl out of that, is going to be the toughest one.
Robert, good luck, and let's take a look at how the players played the championship pair this week. First place, there's oil 41 feet down the lane, but if you'll notice the maple part of the lane where I'm writing this word oil, it's all been resurfaced, so it's very slick in that area, and the track area here has not been resurfaced, so it's kind of rough. Now, it's dry on the back end, so they get a pretty good break. And all five right-handers are going around that track area, around the first arrow, swinging out to the channel, trying to get it into the 1-3 pocket. Now, Chris, there's a lot of money at stake, and I'm sure we're going to have a tough competition today.
A total of $150,000 broken down to the winner, 28, runner-up, 14-5, 85-7-6. That's what we'll see happen here live today from Fairlanes Woodlawn in the Baltimore area. Here's our first match, Tony Westlake on the right, and on the left, Pete Weber. Wide World of Sports lives up to its name again because it's boxing from London, Iditarod from Alaska, and more on the Antarctic Exhibition. It's really a great show, and that'll follow us at 4:30 Eastern Time. And all three of those things, Bo, I'd like to be reporting on today. But we have a great bowling show here and a tough split for Tony Westlake to try and convert.
The 2-4, 8-10, the ball has to get to the left side over here, try to get the 2 to slide into the 10. Very tough, carrying out that back pin.
Crowd here, realizing the disappointment for Tony Westlake, but the gallant effort in trying to convert it. As Pete Weber now is up, this is one of the three Triple Crown winners using the full approach, right lane. Our powerful strike by the 1980 Rookie of the Year. And this is his 50th telecast.
The form that's won over $1 million in the Pro Bowlers Tour. Look at that high backswing, kind of a locked third step, and then a good smooth follow through. Pete not trying to overpower the lanes, just kind of stroke the ball. He's got plenty of natural power. The thing that everybody says is the left-hand lane here, lane 15, is a little bit slicker than the right.
So with the double, Pete Weber puts immediate pressure on two-time winner Tony Westlake of Edmond, Oklahoma. Born in Muskogee, 31 years old, 5'6", 165 pounds. Beautiful recovery after an open frame.
Westlake at 5 feet, 6 inches tall, 165, five-step delivery, short controlled backswing, shoulder high, has good pivot step. Watch that right foot drive off, a little bit locked with his left leg, but see that follow through going directly towards the target. Westlake, one of the great clutch players on the tour, is a man you don't want to get to the 10th frame with because he's awfully tough. He trails by 11 right now, though.
Crossing over and leaving the six pin. Though in Wide World today, we'll really be crossing areas, the entire globe from the top to the bottom. Antarctica expedition, the end of a 4,000-mile scientific journey, and then the start of the Iditarod Trail sled dog race, and that's in Anchorage, of course. And the boxing match is from Wembley Arena in London. WBA World Welterweight Champion Mark Breland, the challenger, former two-time champion Lloyd Hunnigan.
Westlake there, Chris, in the third frame, tried to adjust for the light hit in the first and left the six pin crossing over. He tried to do it with hand action. I think he needs to make a move on the approach as Weber has a chance to get out to a real big lead through three frames. He leads by 21.
Oh, he likes it. Shouting through it and then backing away. One of his trademarks. He got a little of his dad in him in skill and also how he reacts. We asked Pete Weber a question a little earlier, and here is the answer he gave us.
Well, number one, when you're bowling a bad game, don't get discouraged. Number two, do what you feel comfortable with. Number three, don't give pins away. And number four, just have fun.
Well, that wasn't as much fun as the three strikes that Pete had strung earlier, and now he has left the two and sleeper eight, answering the question on advice to youngsters, the junior leagues, so that they would both improve and, of course, enjoy the game.
Double with 2-8, tough spare.
Oh.
Trouble.
First error for Pete Weber. And we have seen it happen many times over the years.
See Weber sliding by, didn't get any hook on the ball. The center of the lane, very slick, whiffs both pins, and he only has a 15-pin lead as we go into the fourth frame.
All right, this is seafood area. Look at the hard shell. Blue crabs, famous here for crab cakes. Ah, yes.
Express mail from your post office has a whole fleet of 727.
We deliver.
A guaranteed morning delivery.
We deliver.
And an overnight price of just $8.75.
We deliver.
Speed, convenience, price. It's a package only we can deliver. Express mail from your postal service.
We deliver for you.
The bills twice as big as usual.
Because, honey, you ate twice as much.
With extra strength, Tums EX, even twice the heartburn's no sweat. It's twice as strong, twice as fast as regular Rolaids.
Nothing's rougher on a man's face than shaving. That's why there's Skin Bracer. It's more than an aftershave. It soothes, cools, tightens pores, so it's good for your skin.
Thanks, I needed that.
Skin Bracer Aftershave.
By Menon.
Very popular gentleman in this area, the American League Manager of the Year, Baltimore Orioles, Frank Robinson, Hall of Famer.
Chris, he's an excellent bowler. I bowled with Frank back in the 60s, and he's a 190-plus player enjoying the action.
Tony Westlake comes up high on the head pin with a spare working. He has left the 3-6-10.
Tony Westlake, one of the few players that ever came out on the tour almost being forced out. His backer, Richard Altman, who will host the last tournament on ABC in July this year from Edmond, Oklahoma. So, Tony, you're just way too good to stay home and bowl as an amateur. So, got him going out here, and Tony has been super for the past 2 years.
Randy Marks with a spare. Okay. Earlier, we asked Tony the fact that he had proven to be a clutch player the last couple of years. How and why?
Well, the first thing I do is take a little more time, think the shot through, and when I get on the approach, I'm never afraid of making that shot. And I'm always aggressive when I throw the key shot.
Excellent shot right there, Bo.
There was an excellent adjustment by Tony Westlake, one you don't see very often. Normally, when you miss to the right, as he did in the first frame, a player will move farther to the right, get more angle of attack. Instead, Tony straightened the line out, moved closer to the first arrow instead of the edge of the gutter, got the proper reaction, and he's lined up on lane 15. This is going to be a close match.
After an open frame, Pete Weber. Then he released it. He knew it was going to come up a little bit high, and he has left the lone two-pin, the man that has 13 titles, including the 87 Firestone, the 88 U.S. Open, and last year's national championship. And later this year, about to marry Kim Schultheis. And they'll do it in Columbus, Ohio. That's scheduled, and we'll be there next week.
Peter, a child prodigy at the sport of bowling, bowled his first sanctioned 300 game at the age of 12, was using a 16-pound ball by that age, and had just done a tremendous amount of bowling. And that's one of the reasons he has such a high backswing. When he was small, he couldn't get the leverage with a short swing.
Pete was on 6 telecasts last year. This is his first in 1989, and this is our 8th telecast.
You see, looking up the lane, you see the high backswing, much like the late great Wayne Zahn, and then there's a perfect shot as Pete drives all 10 pins in the pit.
That one just goes straight by the pocket. Leaves the 1-2-10.
Lane's very slick here today. Westlake having trouble getting up to the pocket on any of his first shots, and he has the washout. He needs to get the ball to the left side of the head pin, and hopefully he can get it over there and knock the head pin into the 10 as Westlake's up quickly, hopefully to make this spare.
Tony Westlake with 86 through the 5th, the spare in the 6th.
Perfect shot. Ball takes out the 1 and 2s. The head pin takes out the 10. And a key shot for Westlake at this point, because if he had opened there, he would have been trailing by 30 pins, and that would have been almost too much to catch Weber. But now we've come down to the crunch part of the match. 4 frames left.
Leaving a 10 on that left lane that he had figured out in the previous shot on that lane.
Westlake, such an opportunistic guy. He qualified here by needing a strike to beat Walter Ray Williams, Jr. He got that. Weber threw a gutter ball against Westlake, and Westlake threw a strike to get in. And then last night he threw 4 strikes in the very last 4 frames to get into the top 5.
Okay, we're nearing the end of our very first match in Baltimore at Fairlanes, and we'll bring it to you, but first this message.
St. Patrick's Day is a time of celebration, and this year, Budweiser and I are making it a time of giving as well. Because this month, I'll be in stores and pubs all across America for the Muscular Dystrophy Association. Give $1 to the MDA, and you'll get a shamrock with your name on it. Look for my Shamrocks for MDA display wherever Budweiser and Bud Light are sold. You can't miss me. I'm the redhead in green.
A kiss? Not right now.
You really don't want to kiss me.
Dangerous. Very dangerous.
Give me a minute, honey.
Don't let morning breath ruin a good morning. Get Scope. Scope has 2 powerful ingredients to kill 90% of the bacteria that cause morning breath.
Didn't I hear something about a kiss?
Right here. Right now. Kiss me.
It is time for a kiss.
Scope, the best thing, first thing in the morning.
Hey, you, put that kiss right here.
WBA welterweight champ Mark Freeland defends his crown against former champ Lloyd Hunnigan. Live on ABC's Wide World of Sports. Next.
Ah, yes, Breland Hunnigan. We're looking at Walter J. Hall, the Fairlane's chief executive officer on the right, with his wife Joyce, and the new chief operating officer of a chain that has 112 bowling centers, Steve Carley, with Wally and Joyce. Now it's Pete Weber, strike up shooting in the seventh.
Pete Weber, very loose. Chris is on the monitors here in the bowling center. He was actually watching the promo for the Hunnigan-Breland fight, which is to follow us, and he was talking about some of the hard punches being thrown. Now, let's take a look at where Weber is playing. He's standing back here on the approach, and he's going to try to get the ball out here around the first arrow zone. Let's watch where he goes. Extreme outside line, in danger of throwing a gutter ball at any time.
Came up high after he begged it to get in there.
Well, the fear of the channel, Chris, is just like an out of bounds to the right in golf. You have a tendency to pull the ball away from the danger zone. Weber, with a commanding lead at that point of 29 pins, left the 3, 6, 9, 10. Here's how he should make it. Get the ball between the 3 and 6 and carry out the 9 and 10's tough shot. Do it like that and he'll maintain a strong lead.
All right. A little nervous. Well, it's a spare for Pete Weber in the eighth frame. Now Tony Westlake, spare up, shooting in the eighth. The man that made five telecasts last year, four in a row. He won at El Paso. Ooh. Tony has to be the finest pool player among all the pros. Well, next Saturday, bowling's biggest names will be in the Buckeye State, and for the first of four stops in Ohio in this year's winter tour. $125,000 Columbus Professional Bowlers Classic beginning at 3, 2 Central, next Saturday. We hope you'll join us, and we look forward to going to Columbus for a bowling telecast. First time.
Big shot for Westlake. Ninth frame, almost a must-strike situation.
Doesn't get it. 2-4-5.
Tell by his reaction, he not only is discouraged with the result, but the way he's playing that lane, his ball was just sliding by, didn't quite break enough in the back 15 feet, leaves the 2, 4, and 5 pins. Westlake must make this spare and hope for a chance in the 10th frame against Weber.
Tony Westlake, runner-up in the 1988 Firestone. He beat Brian Voss and Mike Albee and then lost to the winner, Mark Williams. He is truly a cutch player. So is this 27-year-old with 13 titles. Youngest to win 10 titles at 24. Frame foundation strike.
So important to get a strike in the ninth frame for Pete Weber, because with the dangerous line he's playing right out by the channel, if one would happen to slide off for a gutter ball now, the first ball in the tenth, he'd still have a chance to recover with a strike up. If it had been a spare up, it'd have been complete loss of count and could change the match around. Now he just needs to get 8 pins and 2 balls. That's plenty.
Is, and it's a 9 pin and brings out the wry smile on this young man's face.
Weber
and a smile. And let's see if Kim is smiling, his fiance.
Well, spare strike, and he'd be a 210, and he's the winner of the match.
And Robert Lawrence will be the opponent, the young man from Austin, Texas, who won for the first time last week. ABC Sports presentation, professional. The Bowlers Tour will be back. A message and the station break.
The thinking that went into your Firestone tires took a lot of different tracks. At the toughest tracks in the country, we run in all sorts of competitions. We race a lot. We learn a lot. And it all goes into every Firestone tire we make. Firestone. Watch us. We're on the move.
Got Firestones again, huh?
I've got a one-track mind.
Today, there are more reasons than ever to put your trust in the Century 21 system. Access to more buyers. The exclusive Action Warranty. And year in, year out, no one sells more homes. So if you're ready to sell, call your local Century 21 office today.
Introducing new Extra Strength Rolaids. 250 milligrams stronger than Tums EX. 1,000 milligrams of fast relief. This settles it. Once and for all.
A new California law forcing industry to reveal toxic hazards we never knew were there. Watch Peter Jennings on ABC's World News Tonight next week.
Last week, Como News 4 Special Reports brought some powerful stories home to you. Kevin Coe.
I want to be free.
The convicted rapist breaks a two-year silence and talks only with Como News 4. He says evidence will clear his name. Aviation specialist Rick Price uncovered the story that launched a federal investigation at Boeing. These are the kind of stories we're committed to bringing you each night on Como News 4. So watch for more special reports right here. Watch Como News 4 tonight.
Hi, I'm Chuck Olson, Chuck Olson Chevrolet.
And I'm Chris Olson, Seaview Chevrolet.
We're having a two-dealer sale this weekend.
We've got over 500 cars available for immediate delivery.
That means you win.
You're in the driver's seat. We've got over 50 S10 pickups priced as low as $65.99.
Bring your checkbook.
Bring your title.
Bring your trade-in. That's Chuck Olson Chevrolet.
And Seaview Chevrolet.
Say in Linwood.
In Linwood.
Yeah.
Rebellious teachers demand their share. Watch Sunday at 6. The Pro Bowlers Tour. Brought to you by Old Spice, number one fragrance in America, number one fragrance in the world. By Firestone, watch us, we're on the move. And by Ebonite International, maker of the Thunderbolt for oily lanes and the new Thunderbolt MD for medium to dry lanes.
Well, Pete Weber successful in his first step up the ladder today with a 209-182 victory over Tony Westlake. Let's continue an ABC sports tradition. Up close and personal, Pete Weber. Dick Weber's legendary bowling career has spanned over 40 years, years in which he has won 26 professional titles and has been elected to the PBA and ABC Halls of Fame. Today, Dick and wife Juanita live in Florissant, Missouri, where they raise four children, including Pete, who would become the family's next bowling star.
Even though Pete was 10 or 12 years of age, he was using a 14, 15, 16-pound ball without any problems. And he just had that charisma about him that I knew he was going to be very talented with his game. So that's when I knew.
The Weber's bowling relationship has had a decided influence on Pete's game.
When I was younger, he taught me the basics of the game. If there was something I really needed to know about the game, I had to go to him. He just wouldn't come out and tell me anything. If I wanted to learn about it, I had to go ask him. I know when I'm bowling out on tour and he's not there physically, he's there with me, going through the motions of the game with me, going through my good shots, my bad shots, my good times, my bad times. So he's probably my biggest supporter.
Pete's newest supporter is Kim Schultheis, whom he met in Toledo before his Triple Crown victory. They plan to wed this fall. Pete has two daughters from a previous marriage, and while overcoming personal problems, he remains a fan favorite and a son that Dick can be proud of.
I'm one of those blessed persons that have their sons in the business, a daughter in the business, so I'm a very fortunate father to have kids like that.
And I feel like I'm a very proud son to have a father that's done what he's done in the sport of bowling.
Okay, Pete Weber. So proud of his parents and brothers and sisters. And bowling, really a family sport, like Nelson Burton Jr. and Nelson Burton Sr. And like Tony Westlake, who just lost his wife, Mary, was bowling in the Oklahoma Amateur Championship today in Tulsa. Now Robert Lawrence of Austin. Just like last week. Cool dude.
Well, anybody who did not see Robert Lawrence's win last week in Merritt Island, he started with 9 strikes in a row, shooting a 274 game to win his first title. Now Weber, who should be grooved in, loosened up, ready to get hot.
And he is shot. Here's Weber, who has won over $1 million. A look at the Budweiser Kingpin standings, a lot of money at stake. This is after 7 weeks. Players finishing among the top 24, and you see that Ryan Voss leads by 5 points. A winner of an event like today gets 125. The tournament leader gets an additional bonus total to add to the 125. Inspired by that first win and maybe is up close and personal, and is open with a booming double.
Robert Lawrence, the number 2 average man on the PBA Tour this year with 217 average, trailing a idol, Monacelli, who was spending the time in Venezuela at 218. Set to answer that double of Weber's.
So now there's some reality to talk about here.
Well, the 2-8-10 split, and we see that quite often on a PVA Tour. It's when the oil starts carrying down the lanes and leaves a difficult shot. Player really just needs to get the ball over in this 2-8 zone, and hopefully something will bounce over to the 10. I have never seen it converted in the championship round.
Well, took care of it. 2 and sleeper 8, but the 10, and it's an open frame in the second for Robert Lawrence, who's 27 years old. 5'10", 175 pounds.
Now we'll take a look at the position and angle that Robert Lawrence is playing in the championship round. You'll watch, he'll stand way to the left side of the approach to accommodate that large hook he plays, and he'll start the ball right out in here between the first and second arrows, but watch his position on the approach. He'll be way over here on the left side of the approach with that big hook ball standing out through there. Let's see if he can keep it wide enough to not go high. Right over the target.
Big 274 as tournament leader last week to win his first PBA title. He's earned $36,000 this year. If he wins today, he'll become the leading money winner. $28,000 to the victor. By 22, can increase it to 32. And now Pete Weber has 3 in a row, beginning of the second match for him.
The angle of Pete Weber coming right into your living room, playing that outside line. The ball goes about 45 feet with skid, then goes into a sharp breaking roll. The dynamics of a perfect strike. The ball hitting the 1, 3, 5, and 9 pins, the other 6 pins doing the damage. Weber off to a big lead through 3.
Now Pete Weber has a 4-bagger in our second game of the afternoon from Baltimore, which is the place called Fort McHenry, on the National Register indeed. 1814, the British naval bombarded this for 25 hours. A big flag came up 30 by 42 feet. Francis Scott Key, offshore, wrote the Star Spangled Banner.
The Italians lust for anything American. So in cars, Tonio Liguori prefers an American one. And of all the ways to a woman's heart, he chooses the American way. Cool, clean, Old Spice. No. 1 in America. No. 1 in the world. Only one deodorant in the world has so many odor-fighting ingredients with the cool, clean scent of Old Spice.
Nothing hurts a bowler's performance like an out-of-balance ball. That's why I teamed up with the people at Ebonite to develop the Thunderbolt Dual Block. Its patented weight placement system has a dual weight block to offset the weight removed by drilling with incredible precision, making every roll more stable, every impact more powerful.
The Thunderbolt Dual Block from Ebonite.
1492, Columbus discovers America. Finally, an event worthy of this achievement. The Columbus Professional Bowlers Classic on ABC Sports next Saturday.
Here in Baltimore, let's watch a Pete Weber reaction following four in a row. Ah, yes, the kind of spirit we've found for 29 years on the Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. We're into our second game, and Pete Weber leads by 42 pins. He won the first game over Tony Westlake, 209-182. And here is last week's winner, Robert Lawrence. Strike up.
So, Weber's lead has been cut by 10 to 32.
Boy, what a victory he'll do for you. He was nice and relaxed. Watch the action of the head pins. It goes on the left sidewall. It drives over between the four and seven pins. Gets caught over in that corner and just topples over the seven pin to keep him in the match. Pete Weber off to a quick start with all strikes. Lawrence opening in the second frame. Found himself in arrears by 42. Has cut that lead to 32. One more strike here on the lane he has not missed would make that margin just 22.
Coming in the clutch, 27-year-old Robert Lawrence, Austin, Texas. Willie Nelson's hometown, and he is a fan of Willie's. Who isn't?
Great guy. As Lawrence gets a crossover, the full grip of Pete Weber, uses finger grippers, buries that thumb into a very tight thumb hole, and is in a perfect position.
Set. Only three players, Billy Hardwick, Johnny Petraglia, and Pete Weber, have won bowling's Triple Crown, the Firestone, the U.S. Open, and the PBA. Pete became the fourth to pass the $1 million mark in earnings. He followed Earl Anthony, Mark Roth, and Marshall Holman.
So Pete has the highest average winning per tournament. He did that in 253 tournaments. He averages $3,952 a pop, so he's grinding along at a pretty good pace.
Now, sixth frame. And as we say, we have reached the halfway point. Six in a row. If Pete Weber can bowl six more strikes, $100,000 from True Value Hardware as we watch Pete's reaction to that sixth strike, and a 1990 Chevrolet Corvette from AC Delco. But this is the man that wants to not see that happen, Robert Lawrence. Again, he's back to 32. But remember, Pete Weber is perfect and missed the second game.
Robert Lawrence, a great amateur and regional record in the PBA. In 1989, he bowled in 20 regional tournaments. Those are tournaments held on the weekends over the seven regions of the PBA. And he was 20 of 20 caches.
And here is Sherry, who came up with the sports quote of the week right here on ABC Television Live. When I referred to her, her first remark was, "Where's the money?" Is that glued down?
Unbelievable. A shot we haven't seen much of this year with the long oil pattern the PBA is using, but Lawrence with that powerful hook really gets a tap. Watch the ball cut through the 1-3, and it should deflect into the 9-pin. 1-3-5. So much hook, it actually chops the 5 straight off the 9. A terrible break.
Kissing the 9, it's gone, and it's another mark, a spare, for Robert Lawrence. Meanwhile, the tournament leader, Baltimore's Danny Wiseman, continues to stay loose and sharp off to our right as you hear that pin fall. And now, seventh frame, six in a row. A 10-pin disappointment, but then again, some relief, too.
You could see by Weber's reaction, I watched in the first six frames, he had all the shots going. He could pull it a little bit. He could hook it a little bit, and he knew he had a shot at 300. disappointed as an unobliging 10-pin.
But very carefully sets up to make certain that he knocks the 10 down. And he gave that pin a long, hard look.
For sure. I know what's going through his mind, Chris. When you really get on a roll, he knows he's bowling well. He knows he has room on both lanes. He can pull it a little bit. He can send it wide. And he's loose. He just about has the match wrapped up. Now he starts thinking $100,000 in a Corvette. And it's really disappointing when a ringing 10-pin or a solid 8 stops that type of action.
Come on, baby.
He's right back in the pocket. Big Brother, capacity crowd. It's been that way all week. We'll return to the second game after this.
At BIC, we sympathize with the ways that you pull and stretch your face in search of a better shave. That's why we've created the BIC Metal Shaver. The patented BIC Metal stretches and smooths your skin thanks to its unique metal guard bar, so the shaver glides closely and comfortably. So instead of stretching, start reaching for a BIC Metal Shaver. It stretches your skin for a great shave, and that's no stretch.
Customers, welcome this way. Beautiful thing.
Cool. Ed, look at this. What is it? It says to get Genie Rub Light.
Rub Light?
Rub Light.
It says to get Genie Bud Light!
The clean, fresh taste of Bud Light won't fill you up and never lets you down.
Okay, Ed, now you get a wish.
Bud Light, because everything else is just a light.
WBA welterweight champ Mark Freeland defends his crown against former champ Lloyd Hunnigan. Live on ABC's Wide World of Sports. Next.
Welterweights from London, right here, in bowling a couple of heavyweights. Last week's winner, Robert Lawrence, is going against red-hot Pete Webber. Lawrence is 32 pins down. With a spare up shooting in the eighth frame, the clock is running.
25 seconds to release the ball. Tell you, he's hanging right in there, Chris.
Isn't he, though?
Possible 247. Webber going at a 249 pace. If Lawrence can strike here in the ninth frame, the match could go down to the last frame.
We commented to Robert earlier that he had just recently found great success on the tour. Just who is Bob Lawrence?
Well, I try to be very personable. I don't want to have any enemies out here. I try to give everyone the opportunity to be a good person in my eyes, and I try to be a good person in everyone else's eyes, and try to be everyone's friend.
Isn't that a worthwhile goal? His shot was not that desirable, however. 4-7, left lane.
Well, the best matches bowled all year by these two players. Webber, every ball in the pocket. The only shot that was really off target was a 2-8-10 that Lawrence left in the second frame, and that right now is the major difference in this match, as Webber has it well in hand.
Tomorrow it's doubleheader time in ABC's college basketball. First live at 2 Eastern. It's a game that could help decide the Big Ten championship as Michigan battles the Purdue Boilermakers. Then at 4 Eastern, regional coverage as Iowa travels to Illinois. Illinois wanting to get posture for the NCAA tournaments coming up. And it could be the Pac-10 matchup, Washington-UCLA, for many of you in the western part of the country. Doubleheader, ABC, NCAA basketball, and Webber with a 10-pin.
Good shot there. Stubborn 10-pin once again. Webber has match well in hand, and Chris, I'm looking forward to that basketball tomorrow. I think all the home teams are going to win tomorrow. I like your Purdue team. Illini is one of my favorites, and UCLA are awfully tough at Pauley Pavilion.
Great Big Ten battle with Michigan State up there at the top. They still have to play Purdue and Michigan with... Oh, what talent on that team. And Illinois is exciting to watch. The Illini tournament time will be tough.
Agreed. This man's going to be tough in the semifinal game against Don Moser. Webber with the 3-10 baby split still has the match in hand.
Pete Webber, 145 pounds. about a big backswing, lots of talent, and he will be in the 240s, and he will go into the semifinal game against Don Mosier. Pete Weber winning his second match. And there you see Mosier and Weber. Nelson Burton Jr. now with our tip of the week on the right-hand corner spares.
On this week's bowling tip, I'll show you how to make those difficult right-hand corner spares. The 3-pin, the 6-pin, and the 10-pin. First, the key spot is on the left side of the approach. Look over here, look at the 10-pin, look at the third arrow. That's your spot for all of these right-hand corner spares. Draw an imaginary line from that 10 over the third arrow and check your spot on the approach. This is the spot for the 10-pin. Watch this. All right, we've made the 10-pin. Now the next succeeding pin is the 6-pin. Now how do we adjust for that? It's very simple. Take your 10-pin position and move three boards to the right on the approach. One, two, three, and throw it over the third arrow. That would make the 6-pin. And finally, the last spare on the right-hand side is the 3-pin. An additional three boards on the approach. One, two, three, roll the ball over the third arrow, and you've got all the spares on the right-hand side. Here we go. That's how it works. Establish the third arrow as your target. Find your 10-pin position. For the 6-pin, three boards to the right. For the 3-pin, an additional three boards. You'll cover all the spares.
ABC Sports brings you the ultimate bowling home video.
Now, let's get on with the action.
Learn how to fix your problems the right way. Improve your game strategy. And practice smarter. It's Bo Burton's instructional video, Score More. Just $24.98 plus $3 shipping. Call 1-800-4-ABC-VCR.
Hurry, he's waiting for the tape. Come on, come on.
Now, for all those times when life turns on the heat, a new kind of antiperspirant, Degree.
Ready, camera two.
New Degree is body heat activated. Every time your body heat rises, Degree kicks in with extra protection. Precisely when you need it most, Degree has you covered.
You made it. Punch up camera one.
New Degree protects you most when you need it most.
People do almost anything to keep ordinary nasal spray up in their nose where it can work. Fortunately, there's Sinex Ultra Fine Mist. Twice as fine as ordinary sprays, it stays up in your nose for the best relief possible. Sinex Ultra Fine Mist.
Do it yourself.
Do it for yourself. Do yourself proud with Minwax and Wool.
Wood finish for beautiful color like no other. And Minwax polyurethane for fast drying protection that lasts.
Do yourself proud with Minwax and Wool.
In his first television appearance of the year, Missouri's Pete Weber, winning his second game, 8 strikes, 247 to Robert Lawrence, 211. So it'll be Weber now going against Don Mosier of Santa Cruz, California. And they're practicing here while we look at a final score. It's an upset. Dayton over number 19th ranked Xavier, 111 to 108. NCAA basketball here on ABC tomorrow. A week from today, Bo and I will be at the Columbus Professional Bowlers Classic, Columbus Square Bowling Palace, and then we'll go to, for the national championship in the River City of Toledo, Ohio.
Big tournament there as we looked at the demographics of this tournament. 160 players, average game 204, 213 to get to the top 24. It took an average of 207 to cash. John Mazza, the best finish of the year for him. Walter Ray, Bob Horn Jr., Ron Palumbi up there. Tommy Kreitz, Gary Morgan, Jim Tilton, Mark Bowers, 2,400. Tom Adcock and Phil Ringner, the fireballer. Gary Dickinson for Joe Berardi on the Hall of Fame ballot this year. Latke and Merrill finishing 18th and 19th. Couple good checks. Jack Jurek, Whittington, $1,600. Jess Stayrook, Hamilton, $1,500. And rounding out the top 24, Hilgendorf. And there's that fine trophy that's carried year to year, Chris.
All right, 21st annual Fairlanes Open here in the Baltimore area. Pete Weber, victor of two matches. There he is. Seems very, very loose today. Just as intense as he normally is.
first shot in his third game, this against Don Mosier. He just joined us. Weber defeated Tony Westlake 209 to 182, then over Bob Lawrence 247 to Lawrence's 211.
Going in today's action, for the whole year, the bowler who starts the match has only won 39%, so that would be Weber is somewhat of the underdog starting this match. And let's check after five frames. The leader after five frames has won 21 of 28 matches so far through 7 weeks on the PBT Tour, and that's an average of 75%. So let's see who's leading at five and see if that holds true. Now, Don Mosier.
And the 30-year-old. It started with a strike. He was third here a year ago. It's only his second television appearance, and both have been right here. He lost in a roll-off 40 to 28 over champion Ron Bell.
Smooth arm swing, rolls the ball very smoothly at the foul line. He doesn't loft the ball well out over the line, such as a Pete Weber. Has an excellent arm swing, and you can see by his perspiration, it is really warm in Baltimore today. It makes it very tough to hold on to the bowling ball.
Seasonably warm outside, and Don Mosier is hot here at the beginning with that double. Pete Weber shooting in the second frame, a strike up.
Pete Weber from the overhead, you get a fine view of his approach, taking all 17 feet and the angle of attack.
Oh boy. The man with the big backswing. And follow through.
Well, they're going to have to go after Peter right now. He's loose. You can tell by that nice, smooth follow through, how he waits for the ball at the bottom of his swing. He's not jumping at the shot. Very confident. And really nothing else to shake his confidence the way he bowled in that second game, as he had every ball in the pocket. He's perfect through two this game.
Come on, baby.
All right. Three in a row. Now Don Mosier is quickly up. Doing well here in the East, this West Coast native of Santa Cruz.
25 seconds in which to initiate his approach. You see Mosier on the overhead, more to the center. He'll drift slightly to the right and play that extreme outside line, similar to Weber's.
Boy, they're going toe-to-toe here in the semifinal match. We asked Don what were the circumstances that prevented him from joining the tour at a later stage of his life. Don Mosier's answer.
Well, when I was younger, I had other things in my life. I was married at the time, and bowling just wasn't a main thing. And then when I finally really got into bowling, it was hard to get the sponsors. To get out here, I sold shares, and I finally came out last year, and then this year I finally found someone to pick me up, and so far it's working out good. I'm sure he's happy with it too.
Didn't get the seventh pin. Our statistician today, also from the West Coast, Butch Soper.
Mosier, who is a little bit disappointed in this excellent shot, he rips the five pin over into the 4-7 zone. You see the perspiration. One thing you have to watch, and it happens every once in a while in PBA competition, is when he releases the ball, some of that perspiration comes off on the approach. It's Weber's responsibility to clear it off, not Don Mosier's.
We're in Baltimore with the Professional Bowlers Tour telecast to be followed by a three-part Wide World of Sports. We'll be back.
For great personal service and low everyday prices, check the lineup at your neighborhood True Value Hardware Store. There are intruders at your door, dirt, mud, and grime. So get the March Bargain of the Month. It's the AstroTurf Flare Doormat by Monsanto. Their bristle scrape shoes clean and won't rot or mildew. In March, the AstroTurf Flare Doormat by Monsanto is only $5.44, where you see the banner at participating True Value Hardware Stores and Home Centers.
Many men have sensitive skin that's irritated by shaving. Aftershave Skin Conditioner is clinically proven to soothe and relieve razor-scraped skin. Sensible care for sensitive skin. After.
By Maymen.
I'd rather switch than itch. So I switched to Tegrin.
Tegrin medicated shampoo controls all the major causes of itching and flaking, so Tegrin is more than strong enough for tough dandruff like yours.
Wouldn't you rather switch than itch?
It's a showdown for Big Ten supremacy. Two of the conference's top teams collide as Michigan battles Purdue on ABC's College Basketball tomorrow.
College basketball tomorrow, today, in its 29th year, it's professional bowling. One of the finest, and only 27 years of age. Pete Weber, as three in a row, here's the fourth frame of his third match this afternoon. Almost El Chano.
And we have the 2-4-10. Weber sending it very wide, avoids almost the gutter ball, and he has himself in a position where he has a very tough split. You see it hanging on the very first board, doesn't get back. He's quickly on the approach. He needs to get that 2-4 pin over near the 10, not to be.
So he now goes down by 14. Speaking of follow-through, we're going across the ocean to London. Live coverage of the Breland-Hunnigan welterweight championship bout. Then how about to Anchorage, Alaska, Iditarod? And then how about to Antarctica? The end of the Trans Expedition.
Eight months in the ice. Weber, fifth frame.
At Iditarod, though, 25 teams, over 1,000 sled dogs.
And they keep cutting the time down year after year. But in the boxing match, Chris, which I'm most interested in,
I think
Breland, the young 26-year-old, will at least outpoint Hunnigan. Hunnigan, I don't give him much chance at all.
Both can punch. That was a solid pocket hit, but the seven pin stands.
A wry smile on Don Moser's face. We've seen some real taps today. We've seen the solid nine. Now watch the action, the four pin. The second pin on the left-hand part of the screen. You see the two pin is hit so hard, it drives the four pin straight back instead of into the seven pin. On a perfect strike, the two pushes the four back to the seven. Moser, a bad break.
Don Moser, San Jose, California. In last October, he, like so many, were involved with the earthquake in the area.
And he needed an earthquake to knock that over because the ball was nowhere near the seven pin. We've seen a couple of spares completely whiffed. We saw the 2-8 completely whiffed by Weber, and once again, the seven pin, the center of the lane's very slick.
So right back as these pros do so often following him. Error, open frame for the strike. Two pins now separating these two bowlers, and Pete Weber can increase it, or can get the lead by eight pins, trailing by two, strike up, six frame. Six, ten.
That was a horrible shot. Peter Weber knows it, and it really was a reaction from his fourth frame shot where he sent it very wide. It almost went in the channel, and now he pulls the ball so he doesn't port with the gutter ball, and he's quickly up for the 6-10 spare. Pete Weber, who in his 50 championship round appearances on ABC television here, has had three gutter balls. I remember he had one in Garden City in 83, one in Vegas in 85, and last year at Merritt Island, 1989, he had one in the gutter. So he's had three donuts posted up there, and he was a little fearful of getting another one there in the sixth frame. He trails by two.
Okay. This is a semifinal game. We're at Fairlane's Woodlawn. Trailing by two is Moser, and Did You Know?
Wow, this cleaning's taking forever.
Oh, it's not going too well, is it? You mean you're not done yet?
We're not even close.
Some people have not yet tried Tartar Control Crest.
Oh, I can't believe this.
And some people have.
That was easy.
Because Tartar Control Crest can help make cleanings easier.
A new world's record, eh?
After all, it is the toothpaste more dentists recommend.
Highly commendable.
Great. See you later.
Tartar Control Crest. It's hard on tartar and easy on you.
Do I get a lollipop?
Who gives you guaranteed morning delivery in the U.S. for just $8.75?
We deliver
to over 95 countries worldwide for just $10.75.
We deliver.
With 46,000 drop-off points coast to coast.
We deliver.
Only express mail service from your post office. Because when it comes to sending it overnight or overseas,
we deliver for you.
1492, Columbus discovers America. Finally, an event worthy of this achievement. The Columbus Professional Bowlers Classic on ABC Sports next Saturday.
And Chris Schenkel, a little congratulations on the reward you received from the National Bowling Hall of Fame a week ago Sunday in St. Louis. It's an honor justly deserved. And thanks for all your help with the Pro Bowlers, Chris.
Well, thank you, Bo.
Kerry! Yes!
And it's the pleasure of Don Moser to stay close. He's wearing a wireless microphone. You'll hear his comment from time to time. That is, if we shut up.
Pete Weber grinding on that rosin bag, trying to keep those hands nice and dry. We've had temperatures in years past as high as 104 degrees on a television set. It's not quite that warm out there today, but the obvious perspiration tells you it's above 90 degrees and a lot of pressure.
All right. Apparently, the heat on the lanes not affecting Don Mosier's shot.
Not affecting either player's shot too much, Chris. There is what the lubricity of the oil may carry down a little bit farther on the lanes, but both players are zeroed in. The trouble is holding on to the ball without squeezing it. You don't hold a bowling ball and squeeze it to death. You hold it with a nice, firm grip. And so that's the problem under real perspiration like that.
That one hung on the edge, but came back up into the pocket. Pete Weber can cut the lead to six. Look how close.
Centrifugal force of the bowling ball hanging on the outside board, Chris. And the reason a ball can hang on the outside board is that even in the pine area out there 20 feet, the edge board is made of maple. And it's usually just a pinch higher. Not all the time, but just a pinch higher because it's harder to resurface. And so Weber was a benefactor of the ball hanging on the very edge and flipping back to the pocket. Just slightly disturbed by something on the right, or maybe the perspiration building up in his hand, but right now he trails by 12, has two strikes up, key ninth frame.
Oh! Six to four. Now, the separation is only two pins.
Watch the action of the head pin. The head pin's the key pin here. It's going to the left sideboard. It disappears behind the four. The four, once it gets to a certain tilt, 9-degree angle, it must fall. Weber likes it. The match is on.
But meanwhile, Don Mosier has strung the four. Leads now by 12 pins. Like the old stories, we sometimes get close-ups of their faces, either prior to the release or just after. They have their game faces on, don't they?
That's so, Chris. Both players look confident and determined. 1 year ago, this man could have led the tournament. He left a 4-6-7-10 on his final ball against Monacelli to drop into second place. Right now, he's back in the moment of truth. Can he get a strike here to put Weber on the ropes?
Remember, this is a 30-year-old that has yet to win his first PBA title. Big afternoon for him.
Remember Ron Bell, who won the championship last year, how determined he was in the championship round. Don Mosier likes that same type of action. Bell, unfortunately, could not defend his title because of back problems. Now, yeah. Moser's in a situation, Chris, where he can shut out Weber. If he gets nine spare or strike on this ball, it's all she wrote for young Pete Weber, and Mosier would go against an untested local favorite, Danny Wiseman, for the title.
And it would be like last week, two non-winners in the final game. Bob Lern and Robert Lawrence, who was eliminated by Pete Weber in the previous game, 247 to 211. Danny Wiseman of Baltimore is our tournament leader.
Kerry! Yes!
Oh, yeah.
That's a winner.
Don Moser is one step closer to his first title. ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowlers Tour will be back after this message and a word from our local stations.
When you've got your power stroke going, you've got confidence that nothing's going to beat you. Introducing Power Stick, the new antiperspirant that gives you 24-hour odor and wetness protection in just one wide stroke. It takes two strokes of the leading stick to match Power Stick's one-stroke protection, 24-hour protection. In just one stroke, new Power Stick from Fabergé. Introducing new Extra Strength Rolaids, 250 milligrams stronger than Tums EX, 1,000 milligrams of fast relief. This settles it, once and for all. Barbasol gel gives you a super close shave like the other gel, but at a great Barbasol price.
Your Barbasol gel, sir. Your change, sir.
Barbasol gel. No wonder it appeals to the rich.
Sunday. Everybody remember where we parked.
Don't tell me. You're from outer space.
No, I'm from Iowa. I only work in outer space.
Star Trek IV, The Voyage Home, Sunday.
This is a test. KOMO-TV is conducting a test of the emergency broadcast system. This is only a test. This is a test of the emergency broadcast system. The broadcasters of your area, in voluntary cooperation with federal, state, and local authorities, have developed this system to keep you informed in the event of an emergency. If this had been an actual emergency, the attention signal you just heard would have been followed by official information, news, or instructions. KOMO-TV serves the Seattle King County area. This concludes this test of the emergency broadcast system. Wheel of Fortune, tonight at 7.
Frank Gifford once again from New York will return to bowling for the final match of the day. And immediately following bowling, stay tuned for Wide World of Sports, the WBA World Welterweight title fight, Mark Breland going against Lloyd Hunnigan. Well, last Wednesday, ABC News reported that Charles Shackelford of the New Jersey Nets was involved in a point-shaving scheme during his collegiate career at North Carolina State. According to ABC sources, the 6'10 forward and three teammates conspired to fix the Wake Forest game in the 1987-88 season and as many as three other games. This afternoon, Shackelford addressed the allegations for the first time at a press conference in New Jersey.
I never shaved points at North Carolina State. I did take money from an agent. I was young and I was poor. I was offered money and I took it. I borrowed the money from another person because I thought that was my only way out. What I did was wrong. I know that now. I paid both people back almost 3 years ago. I am not saying that being young and poor is an excuse for what I did. It's not, but it is the reason why I took the money.
We, of course, will continue to follow this story. But right now, let's go back to Chris Schenko and the final match of the day. Chris?
Thank you very much, Frank Gifford. What a big game. West Coaster Don Moser eliminating Pete Weber, who had won two matches, 255 to 234, which means that two non-winners will go into the championship. Speaking of champions, here's a Hall of Famer, Frank Robinson, American League Manager of the Year. How's your bowling average, Frank?
Well, it's non-existent nowadays, Chris, but it wasn't too bad when I was bowling.
Why were you back in Baltimore?
Well, I was back here to do some PR work, visit some kids in the hospital, and do some things for the ball club.
And it looks like you may have a new stadium here, too, in the future.
We will. We'll have one in 1992.
What about the strike? Will we ever play again?
Well, it's not a strike. It's a lockout right now. And I'm very confident we're going to play very shortly. I hope they'll get their heads together this week so we can get to work.
You heading back to Florida?
I'm going to head down to Florida. I came from Los Angeles here, and I'm going to head down to Florida to just take a look at the minor leaguers down there when they start to work.
Well, Bo and I have been very impressed with what you did last year.
Well, thank you. You know, it's very talented players. They were young. They played as a team, and they had an outstanding year. It was a fun year.
Well, you're a great leader, and we're proud of you.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Frank. All right, we'll go into that final match now. On the left, there is Danny Weissman, and wait till you hear his fans cheer. Here is Don Mosier, who won the last game.
Frank Robinson picks Don Mosier, Chris.
All right.
Final game.
Frank likes experience. He has that one victory under his belt here, and he left the 6-10.
Well, give Frank a little statistics, which I'm armed with, and he is, and after 7 weeks, the tournament leader, being Danny Weissman in this case, has only lost one time, Frank. So you went against the odds, but good luck. It should be an exciting match. Thanks for coming by.
Now over in the left lane, still cross lane for the 6-10.
Hear that ball rumbling over the thumb hole. It's basically what the pro bowlers call a kill shot. You want to keep your wrist underneath the ball for the strike on the strike shot, and you want to break it down to kill the roll and control it on the spare shot. Now here's first time ever on television, local favorite Danny Weissman.
Oh, these Baltimore fans are backing their local product, and why not? Here's his form.
Major changes in his game. He has his arm swing in good position. See how he rolls it behind his back? Then it's inside out, right by his right hip and left leg as he comes through. That was absolutely perfect. You don't want that swing as, say, golfers go over the top or bowlers bounce away from their side. You want it inside out. Excellent. Danny Weissman, his first shot.
He's from the Parkville section of Baltimore, his first full season. He's only 22 years old.
Tell you, he just saws that five out, Chris. 22 years old, where do they find him just week after week? Getting tough out here.
And Don Mosier. So he left the two pin. This is our championship match worth $28,000 to the winner. The runner-up, $14,005.
Mosier from San Jose, California, was an outstanding water polo player, was the most valuable player in his high school in San Jose. As you see his ball sliding by the head pin, leaving a two pin. Remember, it's been hard to get over to the left side. He has to go straight at the two. He won't give it any room. Good shot there. No, sir. Right straight by it. See how slick the center of the lane is, Chris? And that's the reason the players are playing that, an extreme outside line. Look at the ball, trying to bite. We know a bowling ball will slide and try to bite in the oil or lubrication in the center of the lane. This ball never, hardly ever bites the lane surface, just misses by a fraction of an inch. Once again, that's a spare that Mosier has missed. He missed the 7-pin in his first match.
But as unsettling as the miss was, comes back with perfection in the third frame. Danny Weissman, the Baltimore Bowler of the Year twice. He has two regional titles. He led the first three rounds and then again at the end of six to make him the tournament leader. Careful preparation. All right. Earlier we asked Danny Weissman, 88-89, you were not too successful. What changes have you made?
Well, first of all, I changed my arm swing. My approach, I had a little hesitation I had to get rid of, and I just watched a lot of films of the bowlers, like Marshall Holman, for instance, and I bowled 20, 30 games a day and worked very hard at it, and here I am today.
Three in a row, fourth frame. Lisa on the left, his dad Albert on the right. That pair and all his fans are happy. A four bagger. More later.
The king! I said, put on some spikes and get the queen a Bud Light.
Oh. Bud Light's clean, fresh taste won't fill you up, never lets you down.
Henry, they're pop tops.
Everything else
is
just a light.
To get rid of her gray, my wife can spend 40 minutes. But I discovered the 5-minute hair coloring.
The revolutionary discovery called Just for Men from the leader in men's hair coloring. Simply apply Just for Men and in 5 minutes shampoo out.
Gray is blended away. The look of my natural color is back in 5 minutes.
That was me.
And it won't fade or wash out.
My hair takes forever, but you look great in just 5 minutes.
The look of your natural color in just 5 minutes with Just for Men.
A standing room only crowd. They're especially cheering hard for local product Danny Weissman, who is the tournament leader and is bowling this man from the opposite coast, San Jose's Don Mosier.
Kerry.
Okay. That double cuts Danny Weissman's lead to 32.
Mosier showing some experience that he picked up last year in the championship round here. Very aggressive, not letting anything bother him, especially that missed two-pin in the second frame. Can put some pressure on Weissman right here with a third consecutive strike in the fifth.
High hit, leaving the 3-6.
Mosier was somewhat worried about holding on to the ball all day long, and that one just slipped right off his hand. Never had the proper direction. A pretty good roll on it. Breaks up the split. Leaves the 3-6 spare. If he converts here, he will be trailing by 34.
Danny Weissman, 5'9", 165 pounds from Baltimore, stormed through the final, match play record of 6-2. And look what he's done. The first three, dropped the third, and then stormed to the top.
First three rounds, 18 games of qualifying. The last three rounds, 24 games of match play finals. He's still in the number one position.
Five in a row. The non-winner, Danny Weissman. Oh, hometown fans and support always helps.
Sure helps. I had it in St. Louis when I had my last victory there, and Brian Voss had it down in the Florida area, and this young man has it in the Baltimore area. And Walt Steinzeck, who is one of the great bowling writers in the country, and Bob Cosgrove covering the action here, said they are really proud of this guy. They feel like he is the man from the Baltimore, Washington area, and he's surely proving it.
Lisa may not make it through. His wife. Oh, yeah. Now again, Lisa and Albert, his dad, cheering. We make the point at the halfway mark with six strikes. Six more. $100,000 from True Value and from AC Delco, a 1990 Chevrolet Corvette. Mosier, spare up.
Mosier hitting light in the sixth frame, has the head pin go to the sideboard, and it comes back as a messenger, but doesn't get the 10 pin. And right now, without a couple of strikes, he'll just basically be a pacer. Watch the head pin. It'll go to the left sideboard. Six misses a 10. Comes that head pin around. Just barely misses knocking out the 10 pin.
All right. Danny Weissman, Don Mosier's opponent. What pressure for him. First time ever on television.
Well, Chris, he's got some examples to follow. Remember Bob Benoit, who rolled the last perfect game in the championship round in 1988 at the Quaker State? That was his first appearance. Then we had Robert Lawrence last week with nine in a row. That was his first appearance. So a little bit is uncharted territory, and they're just really trying to work on their game.
Remember, Don Mosier had a big game and defeating Pete Weber 255 to 234. And now, Danny Weissman, who learned a lot, he said, working in a pro shop.
Started bowling at the age of seven. His first league average, 119. He had that through four frames today in the championship game.
Best finish ever, 10th last year in the Greater Hartford Open. And his entourage of backers, including his wife Lisa, exhaling relief for her and I'm sure for her husband as well.
Weissman just sends it wide, doesn't quite get it back. There's not unlimited area to the right, so if you miss a little bit to the right on a PBA tour, you usually don't get a strike. And right now, I'm sure his sponsors, Sport Plus and Carmen Down Pro Shop from Alexander, Virginia, are just about counting the money, because Weissman, all he has to do is just make a few spares here, and he will turn out to be the winner, knocking Randy Lightfoot out of the Tournament of Champions.
And for Danny Weissman, at the Don Carter All-Star Lanes in Kenner, Louisiana, he finished 14th, so a 10th and a 14th, his top placement thus far in his pro career, which has spanned 4 years, and this is his first full season. And Bo, just almost need a sponsor, a backer, to stay out here, don't you?
Well, it costs a player, and we've posted it before, I would say somewhere between $750 and $1,000 to come out here. As you see, Weissman, the 18 games of qualifying, he led all the way, and then in the match play, Walter Ray got him for a little while, then Robert Lawrence was up there, but Weissman took over in the last few games. Now you watch the position of Weissman, he'll be out here around the first arrow, sliding up in this area on the foul line.
Incidentally, Walter Ray Williams finished seventh in this field of 160 here. So it's a strike for Danny in the eighth frame. Strike up for Mosier, shooting in the eighth.
Absolutely must-strike situation the next two frames for Mosier to have any chance of catching Danny Weissman.
That may be one of the smoothest shots of the afternoon for this 30-year-old from San Jose.
When I first saw Don Mosier last year, Chris, I remember seeing him at Pinole Valley, our opening telecast, the blackout telecast. I thought that he would do quite well last year. He didn't quite pan out. He made a couple of championship rounds, but now he seems to have gotten the experience, the aggressiveness, and the demeanor necessary to handle the pressure of the Pro Bowlers Tour, and he's still not out of this match. He still has a chance.
Come on.
Got his wish.
That'll make Weissman think a little bit right here.
Ninth frame for Weissman. A final LSU over Mississippi, 103-94. Doubleheader on ABC starting at 2 tomorrow. First, Michigan, Purdue. Then Iowa, Illinois, or Washington, UCLA. Sliding by the 2 and the sleeper 8.
Boy, did he get a good break there. It's not an easy spare, and we've seen this missed quite a bit, the two-pin combination by not getting across, but he could have left the 2-8-10, and that would have really opened the door. Now he has to get the ball right in there. As you see, the way to make it is to get the ball right over to the two-pin, let the ball drive through to the 2-8, carry it out. That's what we're looking for Weissman to do. Everybody's had trouble getting the ball across the center of the lane.
He got the 8.
Danny Weissman needs 9 pins on the first ball here to win his first championship. And with his practice and dedication, Chris, he's going to win many more. Anybody who will go out there and practice 20 or 30 games, as you look at Mosier, he knows the predicament he's in. Anybody who practices 20 or 30 games like this young man with that talent and good coaching is going to have a successful PBA stint. 9 pins is the championship. Anything less is still an open door.
That's the most sustained cheering that we've heard on the tour for a long time. Hometown bowler, Danny Weissman. Really giving his backers a lot of great action. He'll be in the 250s, and he is a winner Lisa, his wife, is now finally relieved. All right, we'll be back, but let's go to New York now and my colleague, Frank Gifford.
All right, Chris, thank you. And coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, WBA World Heavyweight Champion Mark Breland defends his crown against former champion Lloyd Hunnigan, live from London. Plus reports on the start of the Iditarod Trail Sled Dog Race from Anchorage, Alaska, and the conclusion of the Transantarctica, the International Expedition, as we literally span the globe. Right now, we'll return to bowling, but first, this message.
I used pressure-treated lumber, and I still have $800 in water damage. How come?
Even treated wood needs Thompson's Water Seal protection.
This patio was supposed to last for years. Now I have $1,200 in damage. Why?
Your concrete wasn't protected with Thompson's Water Seal. Thompson's penetrates into wood, brick, or concrete to form a barrier water can't get past, even when driven by 98-mile-per-hour winds.
Let it rain. This time I use Thompson's, a great defense against repair expense.
Thompson's, the first name in lasting protection.
They weren't expecting a 70-year-old coach, that's for sure. But I held my own.
All right, come on. Come on.
They never even saw how scared I was. All right. I wouldn't have tried for this job if it hadn't been for AARP. They've got a program that convinces employers that it's smart to hire people like me. I'm not old. People are people. Some of us have just had a little more practice. That's all.
AARP, making a difference.
Users of ordinary nasal sprays will do almost anything to keep the spray up in their nose where it can work.
Morning, Morgan.
Which is why so many people now use Sinex Ultrafine Mist. It's twice as fine as ordinary sprays, so its medicine goes up and stays up to give you the best relief possible. You don't have to stand on your head to get relief. Just get Sinex Ultrafine Mist.
There's the winner, 255-201. Victory number one, 28,000 for Danny. Don Mosier, 14-5, 8,500, 7-6.
You worked hard for this one.
Oh, yes, definitely. I've worked so hard for this. This is a dream come true. This is marvelous. First of all, I'd like to thank Wally Hall and Fairlanes. They're great for us. They treat us real well each week, each tournament we go to for Fairlanes. It's been marvelous. Great week. And the fans, this one's for Baltimore. Yes, yes!
All right, you had this great crowd, and you had the American League Manager of the Year, Frank Robinson, cheering you. Okay. Wally Hall, who is the Chief Executive Officer of the vast Fairlanes chain, has the spoils of victory.
Danny, it gives me great pleasure on behalf of all the friendly folks of Fairlanes to give you your winner's check. A worthy champion, no question about it, for the 21st Fairlanes Open. Well done, a great week of bowling, and the start of a terrific career for Danny Wiseman.
Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you.
Let's, Danny, we'll be back quick, but Nelson Burton Jr. is with the West Coast professional here that had a big game against Weber, and he faced a tough view. Here's Don Mosier and Bo.
Thank you, Chris, and a man who has really blossomed into a top player. Don Mosier, obviously your best performance, and I'm sure you want to head to that winner's circle.
Oh, yeah. First time I made it, I was just happy to be there. I was a little nervous. Today I was ready to win. I bowled good. I just got out-bowled the last game. He bowled a better game than me, and I praise him for winning.
How about the spares? We saw guys having a little trouble with the spares today. What happened out there?
Well, I've been having a problem all winter with spares. Me and Randy Stone works here. We have a deal. Every time I miss a spare, I give him $1. And every time I go a clean block, he gives me $5. So far, it hasn't been working out too good for me.
Well, the champion didn't miss any spares, Chris, and I'm sure we'll see him many more times. Nice bowling, Don.
Thank you.
Okay. Danny, how long have you been married?
2 years. My lovely wife, Lisa.
I was going to ask you... You must be in the boss in the family because most wives hurry out here to get the money. Here's Lisa. Please come in. And Albert, your dad. All right, Lisa. I thought you were not going to make it at about the sixth frame.
No, I didn't think so either. I'm not going to make it now.
Are you a bowler, Lisa?
No, I'm not. No. I can't. He
just
doesn't
watches
help
me.
Okay, Dad. I want your reaction. You didn't look too calm either.
I was a little nervous, but after about three blocks, I figured that
He's calm enough to get this.
He has a lot of rooters in the audience.
Oh, yes. That's lots of rooters. From Baltimore here, and I think he made a good showing, had a lot of backing.
Well, Baltimore's a great city. I can't say enough for it. I've spent so many days at Pimlico, and when the Colts were here, that run for the roses, you know, is coming up here on ABC a little bit later on in the year after the Kentucky Derby, but being a Baltimore winner, winning in your hometown, Danny, that's incredible.
It's great. I love it. It's great. Wonderful. Dream come true.
Okay, we'll see you in Ohio next week in Columbus for Nelson Burke Jr. I'm Chris Schenkel saying goodbye from Baltimore, 255-201. The executive producer of ABC Sports is Jeffrey Mason. The Professional Bowlers Tour is produced by Carol Letty. Directed by Larry Camp. Technical director, Les Weiss. Associate director, Patrick McManus. Technical operations manager, Mike Fisher. Assistant to the producer, Robin Stratton.
Coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, Mark Breland puts his WBA welterweight title on the line against former champ Lloyd Honeycutt, live from London. The Pro Bowlers Tour has been brought to you by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light. By True Value Hardware. For quality, selection, and personal attention, make True Value Hardware your store of first choice. And by Sinex Ultra Fine Mist, the nasal spray that goes up and stays up. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, recognized around the world as the leader in sports television.
A promotional fee has been paid to ABC by United Airlines. All across the Pacific, they're playing our song. Come fly the friendly skies.
The American workforce has always been strong and productive, but today that's being challenged by a growing problem, youth unemployment. Too many young people lack the basic skills needed to compete. In the future, those without reading and writing and math skills will have an even tougher time. That's something we can't afford. If we don't correct this crisis in our classrooms and workplace, then America will be left behind. We must close the skills gap now and prepare our young people for today and America for tomorrow.
This is ABC.
The attitude as far as the customer being number one starts from the top, and it works its way down, and it's very clear in every phase of the operation.
Good morning, Titus Will.
We had a gentleman come in the other day, and all he came in for was an oil change. And we washed his car and vacuumed it. The best part of my job is when a customer tells me they've never had better service anywhere else. That is it. The customer is number one.
This graph shows how ordinary gasoline builds up deposits on intake valves. On the road, it can cause hesitation, loss of performance. But when Texaco System 3 gasoline was used, valves actually got cleaner. On the graph, it looks like this. On the road, it looks like this. After five tanks, it gets even better.
Hi, I'm Vanna White. Watch Wheel of Fortune right here on Como TV 4. And Saturday, stay tuned for Front Runners to meet our own Wheel of Fortune contestant coordinator.
Vanna's right. Hi, I'm Steve Poole, and we'll go behind the wheel to meet the whiz who finds the big money players. And if you think his job is hot, wait till you meet the Northwest smoke jumper who fights fires by jumping out of airplanes. What do you think of that, Vanna?
It's exciting!
All on Front Runners tonight!